Rom Guruji here, and today I'm going to be talking about the iPhone 12 launch that happened yesterday. Now, this recap is going to be extremely dumbed down and layman's term. I'm not going to go into the technical specifications here. I'm just going to tell you what does it mean for you. But before we do that, if you're new here, press that subscribe button and the bell icon for all the notifications. And let's get started. So the iPhone 12 was launched in four variants: the iPhone 12 mini, iPhone 12, iPhone 12 Pro, and iPhone 12 Pro Max. Now, for all the Indians that thought this was going to be much cheaper, it is not, right? So the iPhone 12 mini, iPhone 12 cost $69,900 and $79,900 respectively. What changes in the iPhone 12 is it is now much more slimmer. Why? Because it has a new chipset, the A14, which is made up on a 5 nanometer process, and it boasts a 50% boost in the GPU performance. So this is going to be a very fast processor. You have to have no doubts about it. It is better in terms of processing power. The display on the iPhone 12 and iPhone 12 mini is going to be XDR. So obviously the display quality has taken a huge jump and boasts a huge DPI jump. What does DPI mean for you? It is going to be a much better, clearer picture on the screen always for you. Now, the iPhone 12 does not have a fast refresh rate in any of the version. So that's sad to be told. Now, there would be no chargers and earphones given in the box. So that is also something you need to look out for. Now, what is the crazy feature that makes the iPhone 12 costly? Well, the crazy feature is nothing but the latest processor. And also, the Apple has finally decided that they are going to offer protection as far as the screen goes. So there is a ceramic display protection in the all variants of the iPhone 12. Now, coming to the Pro variants are going to get the new super sauce features. What are those? Basically in the camera section. So when it comes to camera section, the iPhone 12 Pro is going to get one more lens, whereas the iPhone 12 just has two. The iPhone 12 Pro and Pro Max will have three lenses. Now the third lens, what does it add? It adds a cinema grade quality to your video recording, to your photo shooting, everything. Now this camera makes all the difference because it allows you to record in a RAW format, that is the Apple RAW format, and it also allows you to record directly in HDR10 Dolby Vision format, which I think is crazy for a phone. Wait a minute, this is pretty crazy. Is it costly? Yes, it's costly. It's going to cost you $119,900 for Apple iPhone 12 Pro, and is going to cost you $129,900 for iPhone 12 Pro Max. So yeah, it's pretty steep. And you're going to invest more for the chargers too. And earphones, yeah. But then again, the camera features are crazy for content creators, video recorders, because it's going to offer you a very simple handheld phone. Obviously, phones are handheld, a handheld device that is going to record such amazing footage right off the bat that it's crazy. So if you're a content creator, you want your phone everywhere, you're a vlogger who likes to shoot extremely rich content, there you go. Go invest the money. iPhone 12 is crazy. iPhone 12 Pro, I mean. But if you're a layman like me and just want to switch to an Apple device, go for the Apple iPhone 11. Why? It's going to be much cheaper. It's going to cost you just 50,000 right now to buy in these sales. It's crazy. Go for the iPhone 11. It still offers you amazing processing power. It's somewhere between 855 plus and 865. So yeah, the processing power is a lot. And you don't really feel the difference when it comes to Apple because their OS is so streamlined. And the iPhone 11 has already received the latest iOS version. So go do that. Now, I hope you liked this recap. If you did, please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one with maybe more technical aspects. If you'd like that, if you will like that, please comment down below. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one.